Listen, when you worship him first, a new truth follows.
Holy Ghost, oh God,
truth you couldn't see before.
Today.
Truth you couldn't know before.
Holy Ghost, oh God, in the earth today. Holy Ghost, oh God, in the earth today. Holy Ghost,
the Holy Ghost
God
is God in the earth today. And you walk with him by saying words. My name is Andrew Hemstrought. Thank you for joining us. If this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe. If this isn't your first time here and these messages are blessing you, then consider becoming a partner with us. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1. Now concerning spiritual things, or things pertaining to the Spirit, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. Now, ignorant, it's actually in the word ignore. He doesn't want you to ignore those things. And who's the Spirit that we're talking about? The Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. He does not want you, listen, he does not want you ignoring the Holy Ghost and the things pertaining to the Holy Ghost. Do you know that's where a lot of churches are? Is they ignore the things pertaining to the Holy Ghost and the Holy Ghost himself. Mm-hmm. In fact, even people that don't ignore the things pertaining to the Holy Ghost ignore the fact that the Holy Ghost is a person and that he's God in the earth today. Mm-hmm. Verse 6, and there are diversities of operations, but it is the same God which works all in all. Who is this God that we're talking about?
The Holy Ghost.
Don't be ignorant and don't ignore. Mm-hmm. Say, don't ignore.
Don't ignore
the fact that it's the Holy Ghost who is God. Mm-hmm. This same God which works all in all. Mm-hmm. Say, works all.
Works all.
Who's the God in the earth working all?
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost. Don't ignore that. Don't be ignorant of it.
Yes.
Don't be one of those ignorant brethren that he's addressing here. Mm-hmm. And he says there are diversities of operations. Mm-hmm. One thing will operate one way, another thing will operate another way, and they have different results. We can see praying in tongues, for instance. Are you here? Mm-hmm. Praying in tongues does something different than other things do, and you can't get the result of what praying tongues will bring you to if you don't do the praying in other tongues. Mm-hmm. Fasting, for instance, if you want the results that fasting will bring you, you have to do the fasting to get those results. Mm-hmm. It operates differently. Does fasting operate differently than praying in other tongues?
Yeah.
But you don't get the results that come through that operation if you don't do it. That's my point. Mm-hmm. Worshiping the Holy Ghost is a diversity of operations. If you worship the Holy Ghost, it will do something to you and for you that nothing else will. Mm-hmm. Fasting won't do it. Praying in tongues won't do it. Those are diversities of operations. Worshiping the Holy Ghost will do something to you and for you that nothing else will. Mm-hmm. And if you don't do the worshiping of the Holy Ghost, you don't get the results that it's designed to bring to you. Does this make sense? Mm-hmm. He, the Holy Ghost, won't become your spirit Lord if you don't worship him. He may be that textually, but he doesn't become. Say, become. Your spirit Lord until you begin worshiping him. Mm-hmm. You open your mouth and say, I worship you, Holy Ghost. It's a diversity of operations, and it will do that to you. Verse 7, the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man. Notice that verse came after verse 6, where he talked about an operation of the Spirit, a diversity of operations. Then he said, the manifestation of the Spirit. If you don't do the diversity of operations, you don't have that manifestation of the Spirit. If you don't worship the Holy Ghost, you don't get that manifestation of the Spirit. Most places don't worship the Holy Ghost. Most people don't worship the Holy Ghost, and they can't go here. That's why a lot of the things that I say will be completely foreign to them, because they don't see it yet. They're blinded to it. They can't go here. The manifestation of the Spirit is given. I am given this manifestation because I worship Him. Yes. Say, I'm given this manifestation because I worship Him. If you don't worship Him, you don't get this manifestation of the Spirit. Mm-hmm. A switch has been flipped. A door has been opened, and a page has been turned. I have become something that I wasn't before. Why? Because I worship the Holy Ghost. I didn't before. Mm-hmm. Now I do that, and I have this manifestation of the Spirit. Say, this manifestation of the Spirit. It's a new manifestation of the Spirit. It isn't new to Him, because He's always been God, but it's new to me, and it's new to everybody in the church who hasn't been worshiping the Holy Ghost. This is a new manifestation of the Spirit that you get to experience and walk in with Him as God in the earth today. I have become something I wasn't before. I have become a Holy Ghost worshiper. And like you, I wasn't doing this before. So I didn't have the results of Him being God in my life, the Spirit Lord, as He is today. It has changed me. If you don't think this is new, then you don't get out much. You haven't done it enough to where you see the new, till you experience the new, until you have the manifestation, the new manifestation of the Spirit. Say, the new manifestation of the Spirit. And He's able to manifest Himself in a way that He hasn't been able to up till now, because you've been ignorant and you've ignored Him. I'm never going back to the old way that I used to be. You mean to the unsaved? No, I mean to living in the Christianity that you live in today. This is different. I did not walk with God like this before. I thought I walked with God, but I did not walk like this. I walked denominationally. That's hard to say, but it's true. And almost all the body of Christ, they're walking with God denominationally, meaning in the confines of their denomination. And that's preachers, we preach in the confines of our denominations, or we get kicked out. Mm-hmm. And we walk and live in line with that. But I see things in a different light now. Even though I believe many of the same things that I used to believe, it's not that I don't believe them, I see them differently now. You don't worship the Holy Ghost, and that makes all the difference. Oh, I would never worship Him as God. Then you will never go here. John 4:24 says, God is a spirit, and they that worship Him. God is a spirit, Holy Ghost, and they that worship Him, that's me, worship Him in spirit and in truth. You can't get to the knowledge of Him in spirit and in truth until you do the worship first. Mm-hmm. Say, the worship first.
Worship first.
You worship Him first, and then after you worship Him, you don't see the truth, and you don't see Him for who He really is until you worship Him. The worship comes first. Did you see that? Mm-hmm. God is a spirit. They that worship Him comes first, not second, not third, not ignored, or maybe we'll add it later. When you worship Him first, a new truth follows. Listen, when you worship him first, a new truth follows. Truth you couldn't see before. Truth you couldn't know before. I live in that truth. I'm learning more of that truth. Are you here? You think adding some Holy Ghost worship at the end of everything else you do will make the difference? It won't. It's not enough. Number one, it's not first, but it's not enough to change things. First, only. If not, you walk around in some religious haze. How do you know? I used to walk around in a religious haze. Compared to this, I didn't think I walked around in a religious haze. I thought I was correct. I thought I was right. But coming from my standpoint now, I can see that these people are walking around in a religious haze. They think they know what they're talking about. They have no idea. You worship him first. God is a spirit. You worship him in spirit and in truth. The word haze means atmospheric moisture, dust, smoke, or vapor that diminishes visibility. You have a diminished visibility. You don't see things as clearly as they could be seen because you put the Holy Ghost last. You tried to tack him on to the end. That's what it's, you know, people listen to my message. If they're not worshiping the Holy Ghost regularly and having that worship literally change every part of them, they'll see it kind of through a haze. They look like they're in some kind of a religious haze. Am I wrong? No. Your preaching sounds like a religious haze to me. I'm saying something that you're not. I'm offering something that you're not. Do what the 99% of people are not doing, and then you'll be successful. Worship the Holy Ghost, because 99% of the Christians are not worshiping him, and I'm telling you, you will be successful. The Holy Ghost is God in the earth today. You can't hide him. You can't ignore him. You can't be ignorant of him and go to where we need to go. Listen, where we need to go is with him. He's the one Jesus sent into the earth to be with you. Worship him. He's God. Tacking the Holy Ghost onto the end changes nothing. You can't tack him on. You can't ignore him, or the haze continues. It's not going to get you here. I used to be in that religious haze. Luke chapter 4, verse 8. Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. What happens when you learn that the Holy Ghost is the Lord your God? You're going to worship him and you're going to serve him. If you knew him as God, you would worship him as God. We don't worship him as God because our preachers have not told us to. I know how it is for you. I was there. I wasn't doing this like I do today. There's only one God in the earth today, and his name is the Holy Ghost. He's literally the one that the Father and Jesus sent to be with you. Get that straight. There's only one God. Say one God.
One God.
In the earth today. And I walk with him. Anything beyond that is a haze, is a fog, is a religious fog that tries to stop you from seeing the truth. The Lord of Spirits is another one of his names, and he's pleased with this. Only is a powerful word. Only separates from everything else. Only consecrates to one thing. Thou shalt worship the Lord your God, and him only shalt thou serve. I didn't used to do this. You'd think that this would be something we'd be big on in the body of Christ. Worshiping the Lord our God and him only serving. The problem is they don't know the Holy Ghost as the Lord their God, because they're not worshiping him, nor can they then serve him in the way they should be serving him. Only. I had one lady, a partner of mine, that wrote and said, "Don't give up on us. Some of us have had grave clothes on for many, many years." She said she's just starting to get it. She's just starting to see. She's just starting to get beyond that haze, that religious haze that clears like fog when you begin to worship him. It's an operation. It's a diversity of operations that does something that nothing else will. It'll clear the fog away that nothing else will. We can't revive the church into something that it was in the past to get us to the future. There is no revival of the past that takes you to the future. It has to be new. It has to be the newness of God. If I say the newness of God, who must it be that I'm talking about? The newness of the Holy Ghost in your life. No revival of the past will bring you to where we need to be. Can you see that? We've already been there. It didn't do it. This is new. I enter into and establish the new, and I bring people with me. I am given a new manifestation of the Spirit. How did I get the new manifestation of the Spirit? How do you get the new manifestation of the Spirit? Is by doing the diversity of operations that takes you there. You can't know him without worshiping him. Go with me or not. Stay where you're at in your little religious haze. Or come with me to where the veil is taken away and things are clear and things are clean and you can understand what you couldn't understand before. When you use the words, "I worship you, Holy Ghost, only," and the only is because he's the only God in the earth today, then all things open to you. Did you hear that? When you use the words, "I worship you, Holy Ghost, only," as the only God in the earth today, "I worship you, Holy Ghost," then all things, say all things, open to you. John 14:26 says, "When the Comforter," who is the Holy Ghost, "is come, he will teach you all things." 1 Timothy 6:17 says, "The living God gives you richly all things." What opens to you when you worship the Holy Ghost? All things. He teaches you all things. He gives you richly all things. The Holy Ghost is the living God. When you worship him, he opens to you all things. Are you getting this? Some people are getting it. Luke chapter 10 verse 38. "Now it came to pass as they went that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus's feet and heard his word." What did she do? She, Mary, sat at Jesus's feet and heard his word. Verse 40, "But Martha was cumbered about much serving, and came to him and said, 'Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me alone to serve? Bid her therefore that she help me. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things, but one thing is needful. Say one thing.
One thing.
One's a very powerful word. Only. Mm-hmm. One thing is needful, and Mary hath chosen that good part. Mary chose to sit at Jesus' feet and hear the word. Jesus is not here in the earth today. You can't choose that good part like Mary did. But Jesus, who's seated at the right hand of the Father, sent the Holy Ghost, who is God, mm-hmm. into the earth today. He is here.
Yes.
One thing only. That's what one thing means, only thing. One thing is needed, is to sit at the feet of the one Jesus sent into the earth to be with you. His name is the Holy Ghost. You worship him. You put him first, not second, not third, not ignored. He's the God that works all in all. Are you here? When you do this, he will begin to reveal in you who he really is, and who you really are, and what you are really called to do. We thank you, Holy Ghost, for this wonderful manifestation of yourself. We worship you. We give you glory and praise in the earth. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have a tithe or an offering, hold it in your hand. Say this after me. Holy Ghost, I worship you. You have said in your word that if I give, it would be given to me. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, would men give into my bosom. That's happening to me now. In Jesus' name, amen.
In heaven, Jesus at his right hand. Holy Ghost, your God in the earth today.